I'm Medina. I'm 16 years old, and I live in Kabul, Afghanistan. When you first hear Afghanistan, what comes to mind? Probably bombings, war, and crime. Girls are not allowed to go out much here in Kabul. But I want everyone to see my country. See it beyond the chaos. See it for the people, the culture, and the hospitality. I'm also Hilda, a 14-year-old from Belize City. I got shot in my right leg a couple years ago during one of many gang wars here in Belize City. Men in my community have been to prison, but they are not bad people. I want to help, train, and counsel prisoners here in Belize after they return home. I'm also Deandra from Jamaica. Jamaica is the land of wood and water, and I want to preserve that distinction. I want to raise awareness of the plight of these marine animals that live in our waters. I want to save them. Don't forget my names. I am Medina, I am Hilda, I am Deandra. But today, I am Kavya Krishna, representing the voices of over 130 million other young girls like me around the world that have goals and dare to dream. I'm a financially independent woman, originally from a developing country, who knows how to code. And in my mind, that is the most prepared state of being for the future, for girls and women like me. Note, keyword that makes the state of being slightly difficult is women. And another that makes it even more difficult is developing country. In 2019, I spent a week teaching coding to Society of Women Coders through these high school girls in Belize City. And this is where I first met Aisha. Just like Deandra, Hilda, and Medina, Aisha came into the camp with no understanding of coding or entrepreneurship. During the camp, she built a website to represent her entrepreneurial project. Through her project, Aisha wanted to solve the issue of sargassum pollution in the Caribbean Ocean. For those of you who don't know, sargassum seaweed crisis continues to affect life on the Caribbean coasts. What happens is the sargassum begins to rot at the coast and accumulates, which disrupts life both inside and outside the ocean. Aisha wanted to clean the coasts of this sargassum and make usable products like furniture and fertilizer out of it. She not only came up with this idea, but she came up with a whole business prototype of how she will collect it, utilize it, and set up a community selling service. She even incorporated forms for volunteer sign-up in her website, all in a week's time, from scratch. Hilda was part of the same camp, and her project was an online portal for prisoner counseling. Medina built a website to promote tourism in Afghanistan in our virtual camp last year. And Deandra built a project to preserve marine life in Jamaica during our climate hackathon this year. So what I want you guys to pay attention to here today is that these teenage girls from all around the world have the aspiration to solve some of the greatest issues of our world: economic development, climate change, criminal rehabilitation, and war. And they saw an opportunity through these camps and made use of the platform to gather the required technical skills in order to take that first step towards solving something that affects them. Reason being that their survival and happiness is entangled around these regional issues that make for the bigger global problems. Opportunities like these camps are rare in these communities, but are exactly what is needed to foster sustainable solutions to our global problems. With skills like coding, girls can be steered to solve local issues, to make money, and to change status quo. 3 years ago, we started Society of Women Coders to create an army of such girls around the world. And we have directly impacted over 1,200 girls in 27 developing countries all around the world by introducing them to just two things, coding and social entrepreneurship. A survey done by the World Economic Forum suggests that 42% of the core job skills required today will change substantially in the coming years. Pushing more women towards learning digital skills is the best way to ensure their financial security and independence in the future, and especially in underdeveloped and developing countries. The fight of the future is not going to be about Excel sheets or PowerPoints. It's going to be about not becoming obsolete. And to stay relevant, we need our girls updated on the most lucrative skills of our time, coding and financial literacy. So the goal is to help more women attain financial independence in the coming years, and efficiently so with education, career, and jobs in technology. Let's talk about financial independence. How many here think that financial independence makes for happier women? To me, that sounds like a fact. But to back it up, there is research and studies that show that a direct connection can be drawn between the economic dependency of the women on the men of the household and the victims of mental abuse and domestic violence. Financially independent women are less likely to fall victim to mental abuse and domestic violence. Financial independence helps women to be more confident, free-willed, and better leaders, which not only makes them happier, but leads to happier families and a more wholesome life. So I know I threw a lot of information at you all here today. Keywords: future, women, tech, developing countries, financial independence, happiness. I would like to point out that there is a gap between how we perceive happy women and what science and surveys point out. Humans have been able to imagine a society on Mars and send a Tesla in space, but the notion of equality here on Earth is still strange to most. So we have to prepare our girls. We need our Madinas to know that they are equipped with the coding skills required to build an app for tourism in Afghanistan and even build a business around it in the future when they grow up. We need our Hildas to know that training and mentoring prisoners can be done through a socially funded venture that will not only employ her, but allow her to create employment for more girls like her in Belize. We need our Deandras to be confident enough to start their own nonprofit organization and save the wildlife around the world. We need our girls to know that they are capable and ready. Society of Women Coders aims to create opportunities for young women through technical training and mentorship. And more importantly, change perceptions in the communities that need it the most. Teaching young girls early on that they do not need a fairy godmother to help them fly. They can make their own wings made of code. Thank you.